So although it's really nice to have OneNote available for our own use and our own note taking and references and information, we're probably at some point going to want to share some information. So I'm going to give you a few examples of how you can go about that sharing. So you're going to have an example of how you can share just one page. You're going to have an example of how to share a notebook from within OneNote. All right, so let's go into it. So let's say I want to share this page of my notebook with somebody. I want them to have access to this information that I've recorded here. So how I'm going to go about this is I'm going to click on share at the top here. And if I want just this page to be shared, then I need to go to email copy of page. So let's click on that. Now notice it took exactly what was on my OneNote page and just put it into the body of the email. That's how this works. So this is just a copy. I'm sharing, but I'm sharing it as a copy. They're not getting access to this page in my OneNote. So if I've taken the notes for something and they're asking for a copy of it, this is how I can easily send it to them. I didn't need to copy and paste anything. I just said share page and then to the email. So let's email it off and then I'll let you see it from the recipient's point of view as well. So once I email a page, by the way, nothing in OneNote shows me that that page has been emailed. Of course, I would have a record of it in my Outlook, but it's not necessarily saying it's coming from OneNote, just so you know that. Let's look at what the recipient received when they received this page, right? So very much like how I sent it, this is how the recipient will see it. Now there's one more way of doing this and it's pretty much, it'll do the same thing, but it might be a bit more convenient to use. I use the share button to do the emailing the page, but actually if you look at the home ribbon at the top of our screen, there is an email page button available for us. And if I hover on it, it even says that there's a shortcut key for it, Control Shift E. So if you like shortcuts and you won't expect to be doing this a lot, then you might want to memorize that shortcut. So I'm going to click on email page and gives me exactly the same thing. You know, I actually didn't notice this before, but it does say created with OneNote at the bottom of that email message. And by the way, if I did want to put my signature line in, I'd still have to do that at the bottom of this email message as well, because it doesn't put it in there automatically for me. So the email page button is exactly the same as the share button in terms of emailing a page to somebody else. Okay, I'm going to cancel this because I've already sent it. And let's say that's not really what you were expecting. You really want to share everything in this notebook with somebody else. So if you want to share the entire notebook, then you can use the share button that we were just using. So here are your choices. You can share one page, by doing that email as email the page, or you can share all pages from all sections of one notebook. So I'm going to pick this notebook that we're in right now, the K2 sample 2, and I'm going to share it with somebody. So let's click on the share button at the top. And so again, it's going to share every page, every section of this particular notebook. Share entire notebook is available to me right there. And now you may have seen this share screen before because it's available anytime you share anything within the Microsoft suite of products. So what you want to keep in mind is there's two parts to this. There's the send link part, which really is going to send an email to somebody, whoever you're sharing with. So you don't have to use the Outlook to send the email. It's going to send right from here. And then there's the other part here. It says copy link. So that's going to create a link for this notebook that you can then paste somewhere else. So maybe you're pasting it in a Teams chat, or maybe you're pasting it in an email you already have composed for this person. But you don't have to use both of these areas, you just pick one. So I'm gonna pick send link so that I can send this email right now to the person that I'm sharing the notebook with. And so the second thing I need to look at before I start adding the people in is that anyone with the link can edit is showing right now on my screen. I want to click on this and see what my choices are. So now depending on your organization, the choices that you have available could be different. Your IT department or your IT provider could be restricting what you can share. So if you don't have the same choices as me, it could be that you need to talk to your IT people. By default, these are the choices you have. You can share with anyone inside or outside of your organization. You can share with just people within your organization. So I'm just going to click on these as I say them. I can share with people with existing access, which you know, right now there is nobody. This is just my own notebook, so that doesn't make sense. But it could make sense if I had created this notebook in an, you know, maybe SharePoint or in Teams already. I could share with people you choose. So that one is, it's saying that share with specific people you choose inside or outside of your organization using their name, group, or email. Any, it's very similar to the anyone example. If I click on this one again, this one says doesn't require sign in. So that's suggesting that if you pick someone and you're not sure, do they have a Microsoft account, that they can actually still receive this and get and access it via the web. And they, of course, could download a free version of OneNote as well, or just use the web version of OneNote. Okay, so I'm going to keep it wide open and just say anyone. And then just notice with anyone, I have these settings at the bottom here. I'm going to click on these options again and just want you to look at the settings are going to change depending on the option I pick. So anyone gives me settings I'm going to further work with. People in my organization, I do have one setting available to me. People with existing access, there are no settings because they already have access. People you choose have one setting as well. So anyone, let's go back to that one. I like that one because it's got the most settings. So can edit. So do you want the person or people that you're sharing with to be able to edit this OneNote notebook? Do you want them to add to it, delete stuff, change stuff? Do you want them to edit? If you do, then you leave it at can edit. If you don't, then your other option is can view, meaning that they can't change anything, but they can read it. So it's like a book to them. So that might be good to do if you've made an employee manual of some kind or some policies, and you want everybody to just have access to the information, but you don't want them changing it. So can view. I'll keep mine as can edit. And then I do have an option, regardless of what I pick there, that lets me have a date. And so that date option is letting me say that there could be an expiry date for how long they have access. So if that makes sense, you can put an expiry date on it. I'm not going to put an expiry date on access. I want them to use it all the time. And I could have one more level of security for myself or for them that requires them to use a password to get into this. Now, keep in mind, when I say share with anyone, it is sending them the link. Once they open it, that all they're getting access is to that one notebook. Whether I have 100 notebooks or 10 notebooks, they still only have access to the one I shared with them. And they can't access anything else that I have on my Microsoft cloud. So if you set a password, you know, that's up to you. That, you know, creates that extra layer of security for you, but I don't feel like it's necessary. So I'm going to hit apply. So I've changed this here, and now I'm ready to type in who's going to receive this link. So I'm going to type in another person here. Okay, so you can see that's an email address that's not associated with my organization. So I'm just going to click on that. So an outside person. And it tells me outside of your organization. I just wanted to pick that so you know that anyone would let me do that. And then I have a message area here. And of course, I can add more people at the top there if I want to. But I'm going to just add that one person. And in my message, I'm going to say what it is I'm sharing with them. Okay. And remember, once I've done this, I've picked the person, the email address, I've made my message. Once I've done this I send it, it's going to send it out and they're going to have access to that link. So I'm going to hit send. And now it says link to this K2 sample has been sent. So I'm going to close out of there and then I'll show you what that's going to look like for the receiver. Okay, so here is the email that was received by mission@explorenet.com, the receiver, and it says Connie Clark shared a file with you, and it shows the notebook file, and it has a place for them to click on the link to open it. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the open. Okay, and so I had to wait a bit for it to load on the web, but it did open the web version of OneNote. And so I can certainly use it from here as that recipient that is sharing the notebook. I can certainly edit. I'm just gonna say, hi from mission@explorenet. Okay, And of course, the recipient of that notebook could certainly add pages, add sections. They can edit this notebook. Now, if the person that received the notebook has OneNote on their computer already or on their phone already, they can certainly open up this notebook from there as well. So right now, being that I'm on the web version of OneNote as a recipient, I can go to editing and I can choose open in desktop app. So I'm not going to do that because I already have it open as the other person, but this recipient can do that. So if they already have OneNote on their computer, which most likely they do, they can open it that way. But even if they didn't, they can still get access to it through the web. Okay, so that's sharing your entire notebook with somebody else within your organization or outside your organization. Pretty easy to do, isn't it? Now, let's say as the person that shared a notebook, I want to keep track of, well, who did I share this notebook with? And maybe I'm even changing my mind about who I want to share it with. Maybe I don't want them to have access to that notebook anymore. So if it's my notebook, I created it. It actually lives on my OneDrive. I'm really in control of it. So I can stop sharing it at any time, and I could add more people to it as well at any time, and that's going to be through using the share button again. So I'm going to go to that share button and share entire notebook. So that's where I would go if I want to add another person that I want to share this notebook with. I'm not going to do that right now, but let's go to manage access. So under manage access, I have the option to actually stop sharing. So I'm only sharing with one person. So that's what I can do if I don't want that person to have access anymore, is I just click on stop sharing and it says it'll delete all links, giving them, they won't have access to this notebook. They can't, I mean, if they know about it ahead of time, I suppose they can copy and paste stuff out of it. But if they don't know what's happening, then they're just not gonna have access. They'll click on the link and it won't do anything. It won't let them go anywhere. So I'll just say stop sharing and then close out of there. So if the recipient tries to click on that link again to open up that notebook, they will find this message. The link has been removed. Sorry, access to this document's removed. Contact the person who shared it with you. And then that's the message that they get. Okay. So you can stop sharing a notebook if you want to.